Look, all the way from the depths of hell, we are Wonder Wheel! And all we need from you is a word, any word at all.
Balloon.
I heard balloon.
So you go with balloon.
I have loved balloons ever since I was 5 years old. Big balloons, small balloons, balloons shaped like giraffes, balloons shaped like people. Balloons are my friends.
I really love the balloons because they make that noise when you rub them together. It's this little squeal like an animal. Sometimes I think balloons have souls. That they have hopes and dreams and aspirations.
My best friend was a balloon. Back when I was 5 years old, I was at a carnival and this carny made a clown. He made a clown, a balloon clown for me, and it was, he understood me. But he was empty inside. Like me.
I just like have this like secret ability to be able to like look someone in the eye and tell if they're empty or not. So, it's hard to lie, but most people are. But I guess that brings us together, kind of like a big clump of balloons.
Kind of like my first family. All of them together with me. I loved them so much. And then one day, I tripped, and I fell, and away they went. And I said, no, no, don't leave me. Don't leave me. But into the air, and into the clouds. Do all balloons go to heaven? They did. I think we have a pretty good first family.
What?
Sorry, I didn't mean the first thing. I meant that you and I, you know, most people get divorced and remarried in the course of their lives, probably statistically.
Uh-huh.
And I just think I really like our kids and our marriage. And I think that the first one's going really well.
See, the thing is like when a TV show is only intended to be a first season, you don't call it a first season. It's just an experience. But I'm sorry, but I just think that when you say first family, it means you're thinking about the second.
I guess I'm just not putting as much of the emotional aspect to getting divorced in there. It's just... Look, I mean, my parents got divorced when I was really young, and it's just kind of sat with me ever since, and so I feel like I could take it. But I'm just saying, I think we have a good one right now. It's...
Dad, can you use your fingerprint? I want to go on your Tinder.
Yeah. It's a remnant of when I was dating.
What?
I haven't.
You have a Tinder profile?
Yeah. Just in case, it's not. I'm not actively looking.
Don't touch me!
Okay. I'm not actively looking for someone, you know? It's just, I'm keeping kind of like tabs in case it goes sideways, which statistically it will anyway.
Oh, statistics, we're more than that. You know, I
are we? I'm 5'10", that's the average height for me.
But, yes, we might on paper. paper look like statistics? Like, yeah, I'm 30. That's the average age, right?
I'm doing it. I'm working.
Do it like you mean it. Put a little more heart into it.
Look, I'm trying to put heart into grave digging, okay? It's difficult.
Feel sad for the guy, alright?
Sitting here looking at his pictures.
Well, am I not supposed to feel sad for him?
Look, you can feel sad, just don't let it affect your work, okay?
You're heartless. You know what, Buck? Start a family grave digging business. That'll be a good idea.
It is.
Little did I know, you'd be workaholic about it.
Hey.
What? Whoa. Don't come into my workspace. this is my zone. This is the digger's zone, all right? You're the manager, you stay in the manager's zone.
Whoa. It's that kind of attitude that gets you not anywhere.
Not anywhere.
It gets you not anywhere, not no way, not no how.
I suppose it's that education that made you a man.
The education to be a good leader. My point is, this isn't your zone. This isn't my zone. It's their zone. It's all of our zone. Don't you get it? Don't you see? It's the great level. No matter what level you're at, we all end up on the same level. 6 feet below. And you gotta, what?
Take the shovel. You wanna be in the zone so much? Get in the zone.
All right, wise guy. I'll take it.
You can take the shovel. You can. All right, great. Take that.
I'll take that.
Yeah. And I'll look at these numbers. Oh, we're in the negative, oh, Jesus Christ.
Yeah. All because of that punk-ass attitude that you got all the time, all right?
What the hell are you doing up here?
I'm watching you work, it's stressing me out.
I'm watching you, man, it's stressing me out.
I'm watching you stressing me out.
How high can these stress?
What?
Digging.
You're right, that feels great.
I think I fixed the problem over here. Yeah, no, we're good.
What?
I didn't take into account the Hendersons.
The Hendersons. That's right, because I forgot about them a long time ago.
Whoa, don't get up there.
I need to soliloquize.
That's Carlos' soul.
I'm emotional. Let me have this moment, okay? The Hendersons, they're not just any ordinary folks. They were good people.
Are you talking to...
Talking to no one, okay? Pull them aside.
All right. You're doing that.
They were good people. They were my people. And I let them slip through my fingers like dirt in the grave.
Look, that's enough. Oh my God, this is horrible. I can't be in that zone.
My membership. I will not be a statistic!
Okay, that's fine. meet people who live in New York City.
Look, I went to Lululemon, I got an athletic gear, I bought a juicing membership. I can't do this part. Every day I'm gonna put on my leggings, I'm gonna pick up a big bucket of water, and I'm gonna dump it on myself so it looks like I ran. My parents are dead, and now I have a bucket of water.
But not the actual health benefits. And the looking sweet in, like, bikinis and stuff.
Look, you're great. You're wonderful. And I'm excited for our yearly trip to the Bahamas.
Yeah!
But I'm just gonna get a one-piece flowy moo-moo. I'm not telling you what you have to do, I'm telling you what I'm going to do. Water, a moo-moo, and dead parrot.
All right, boys, line on up. Show me who doesn't have a black, dead soul. I quit dating.
Yeah, I'm 18, and I just got on my dad's Tinder, and thought that, like, we could be a thing, you know? I'm really mature. My parents are going to town with dudes. Yeah, that's me.
Oh!
Not what you were expecting.
No, it's crazy. I look 19 plus. I thought that.
Okay.
Yeah, but.
Now, when I saw 19 plus, I was like, it's gotta be closer to 19, though.
Yeah. I do aerobics and stuff.
Yeah. It kinda looked like you just kinda threw a bucket of water.
That's what they want you to think. Oh. You know? Like, that's what mature people do. You
right.
know? Like,
right.
19 plus year olds. Anyway, crab cakes, huh? I'm gonna order crab cakes.
Is it real crab? Right, date. It's going super.
I'm just 19 plus.
Okay.
19. I have a job.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't have one of those.
So I'll be paying for this then.
I'm sorry, this movie is rated R and we need to ID you both. Anyone at any time.
Don't read that aloud.
19 plus, you're good to go. And. Come on.
Just say that you're my son.
This says you're 16 minus. You can't see this movie, young man.
Okay. All right. So for a driver's license, we're gonna be your date of birth. So it says
19
on or before 19.
Yeah.
On or before 1990.
It's like milk.
Yes.
Sure, I'll chug this. You could, right? You must be lactose intolerant.
Death is boring. There's nowhere else for us to go. That's the difference.
Well, how come you can come in my coffin, but I can't come in yours?
That's an access issue.
Are you guys, talking about me? Can I join you guys?
Yeah.
Lonely in my coffin.
Yeah, come on. Come on in. Well, I guess not.
Whoa.
Kind of blows.
David?
Yeah?
Whoa.
What are you guys talking about over there?
How nothing really changes in death. And we can't... Well, I seem to be able to visit everybody.
This is my punishment.
You know,
I'll join you in this. You got a mausoleum. It's nice.
Yeah. Wait, now I'm lonely.
I'll be back.
Sure. Death is weird, right? Crazy. It's like you thought you were going to be some... I thought I was going to be surrounded by balloons and my grandma. But I'm just here. The smell of dead lilies. Why won't anyone pick up the lilies?
Yeah, those Hendersons, they're in a better place now.
I'm dedicated to our sex life this year. I am not giving it up early.
Don't.
Sticking to it.
Do it.
Okay?
Yes.
It's gonna keep coming at you all the time.
Excellent.
I'm kind of bored.
What? I was just about to turn it on.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah. Oh, okay, yes. I'm dedicated to it. I'm gonna stick to it. We're gonna do it.
You're like less enthusiastic about it now.
No, I'm good. I'm good. I'll I bought like a lot of stuff. I'm sorry, wet.
So you want me to not let you be able to have children because your parents died? What?
Yes.
I'm gonna cut your junk off. You want me to do that?
Yes, I want it gone as soon as possible. I am honestly very nervous that I might make a mistake and accidentally create children. And so this might be the most permanent way, but it is the most effective way, for sure.
All right.
Really? It's that easy?
I wasn't doing anything else today.
Okay. Alternative. All right.
I think we can still do it without. We can still do it without. We can't. We don't need to god to appease to sacrifice someone. Let's just do it.
What?
I agree with David. I think we can just sacrifice someone just for the hell of it.
That's the best part of our religion.
Guys, I think just like without like sacrifice, like being atheists without like believing anything, I think sacrifice is just murder.
I don't need her. I'm sorry.
I guess it's you.
You can just sacrifice the foot.
You're totally numb at this point.
You're
there we go. You're fine. What are you doing?
I came to help.
You're in the
So how did you die?
Joined an atheist cult?
I fell in the hole.
I told everyone my parents were dead and then got prosecuted for their murder.
My brother was distracted giving a monologue.
Lend me your ear.
Wow. I'm a fire rescue man, but I'm so distracted by your lyrical physique.
The fire rescue man.
If only my brother were here now to console me, but this is the reason why I can't be consoled.
He's
not here.
I have a rope, but I just can't help but listen to you.
There are people who can help.
And now, with this shovel that has been passed down for generations, I will begin burying my brother.
I have a little
crane.
What?
A little crane?
I have a crane.
Like cranes.
Crawling. Jeremy, there's an old story when God said
I've been hearing about.
Story, Jeremy.
I remember a story you once told me.
Tell it.